Back in the older Animal Crossing games, Tom Nook's store, where you would buy furniture and tools and whatnot, may have started off very simply, but over time, the more bells that were spent in the store would be remodeled and would look different and offer more variety for players to buy. But over the 22 plus years of Animal Crossing games existing, we've seen many different iterations of what these stores look like. And it's really interesting to compare how one store looked in one game versus how it would look a couple years later in a follow-up game. And the little changes are quite interesting. So let's take a closer look here. Now for this video, we're mostly only going to be looking at the English versions of these Nook stores, but for the sake of being thorough and including the entire franchise, we are going to start on Animal Forest, which released on the Nintendo 64 exclusively in Japan, just so we can see the full evolution of what Nook's Cranny evolved into. Now most Animal Crossing fans are familiar with how Nook's Cranny looked in the original Animal Crossing game. It looked like this really rundown shed, though in the N64 version you can notice a couple of little differences here. On the outside, besides the Japanese writing on the building, on the side where the logo is also replaced with Japanese writing, and inside the store itself, Tom Nook's apron doesn't have the regular leaf logo on it, but instead it has some kanji on it, which apparently translates to shop. Also, just a little thing worth noting, if you look at the pots in the bottom corner of the store, you can see that these are actually just 2D sprites, something that would be changed in the GameCube version. Also, in this first generation of Nook's Cranny, they sold clothes in these stores because the Able Sisters weren't in the N64 version, and even later on in the GameCube version, the Able Sisters were really only there for customizing designs, not really selling clothing. So by the time the GameCube version would release, there would be changes to Nook's store ever so slightly, with those leaf logos on the exterior of the store and also on Tom Nook's apron. Those pots that are in the front of the store are replaced with 3D models of pots instead of the 2D sprite. And while we won't dive into the international versions of every single Animal Crossing store upgrade, I do want to point out in 2006's Donwu Senlin for the IQ, released only in China but based off the N64 version, the logo on the side of the store has this red and black coloration instead of what we see in either version of the other versions of Animal Crossing. In 2005, Animal Crossing Wild World would release and we would see a different version of Nook's Cranny, this time being slightly bigger on the outside than before with this little extra part attached to it, despite the fact that on the inside it doesn't really seem too much bigger. We're still in a shed, but the items in the inside are rearranged in the order of how they are presented here. Furniture is now placed in the back of the store, and there's no clothing items this time around. Also, those pots in the bottom corner are back to being 2D models once again. This was also the first game to introduce Nook Points, which was like a rewards program for buying and spending bells in Nook's store, which you could exchange for cool stuff. So we also have this ABD ATM type thing in the front of the store. Moving forward to Animal Crossing City Folk, Nook's Cranny looks almost identical to how it did in Wild World, except graphically this time around, it just looks a little bit better. The pots are back to being 3D again, and interestingly enough, when it comes time to eventually upgrade your store, Tom Nook will ask players what type of store they like, and they'll end up dictating what type of store you'll get in an upgrade for the next variation of the store. So we'll talk about that a little bit more after we're done with talking about Nook's Cranny. Next, we're going to Animal Crossing New Leaf, which did not actually have a Nook's Cranny, though it very obviously is the same store, just renamed this time around called Nookling Junction. And since Tom Nook had a different role, being in charge of mortgages and housing and whatnot, Timmy and Tommy would be the main store owners here. Now, even though this store, now called Nookling Junction, has a different name, it still aesthetically is the same, though the prices here were higher and sell prices were worse, since New Leaf also introduced the whole retail option in the game. This also might be why in New Leaf there aren't as many items in this version of a Nook store, because you could get items from other avenues. Also, it's worth noting the exterior, while being similar to City Folk and Wild World, is flipped around this time, and by now you've probably noticed that some of the tables have been moved around on the inside as well, like this table's now over here, but it still was based off of the original Animal Crossing Nook's Cranny. Now, Animal Crossing New Horizons is interesting because this game definitely more or less reduced the involvement of upgrading your Tom Nook store significantly. When you first get to the island, all you have is a simple tent, and you can buy a couple of items, but the main goal is to build a Nook's Cranny. Now, once you do get enough items to build Nook's Cranny, you get this store, which does look quite a bit different from the older versions, but you can very much still tell that they were playing a visual homage to the older Nook's Cranny store, and this one is just outright called Nook's Cranny. I do have to say the inside is a little bit nicer. The windows are different on the outside, and it's actually made of wood this time. But yeah, it's a charming little store. Eventually, you do upgrade the store, still called Nook's Cranny, interestingly enough, when you get to the next and final upgrade, and it's still relatively small, maybe not as fantastic as some of the other games' upgrades look like, which we'll get to soon, but with the addition of having a cabinet, a lot of the items that used to be available to buy on the table are now just in the cabinet, which free up a lot of space, and there's just more furniture on display. Still, when you see how over the top some of the store upgrades in previous Animal Crossing games would get to, you kind of miss how awesome those store upgrades were, because I still think they were kind of cooler. Now, while we didn't get many upgrades or any evolving versions of the store after this version, it is worth noting that the store's exterior does change based on what season it is. For instance, you can see what it looks like here in the summertime versus what it looks like closer in the winter time, the spring, or the fall time. And inside, Timmy and Tommy's uniforms will change based on what season it is. So there is a little bit extra here that is kind of cool, but I still wish we would have gotten one more upgrade after this one. Typically, in any Animal Crossing game, after you've spent a certain amount of money in Nook's Cranny, Tom Nook will let you know that the store is going under construction and will be remodeled soon. And starting with the GameCube version, Nook N Go was the first upgrade most players experienced, which was this gas station convenience store type theme for Nook's store. It had this cool fancy sliding door, and it actually looked like a store this time that was at least built up to code. It doesn't look like you're gonna get tetanus just for standing near it like you did with Nook's Cranny. It also has this big, nice sign to it as well. Inside, there's room for two furniture pieces along with two clothing items in the original GameCube version. In Wild World, they took the furniture and moved it over to the left side of the store, something that would be carried over in City Folk as well. And honestly, I try to spend a lot of time looking for the differences between this store in Wild World and this store in City Folk, and what I found was crazy. This gap in Wild World isn't there in City Folk. Yeah, that's about it. With Tom Nook out of the picture in Animal Crossing New Leaf, Timmy and Tommy have their store still redesigned into the theme of a convenience store, but instead it's called TNT Mart, which is pretty much a similar look to how Nook N Go looked, except that darn ATM thing moved again. And then, of course, unfortunately, the convenience store idea never came back for New Horizons. The next upgrade after we had Nook N Go was Nookway, which essentially was just a bigger variety store. It was green. This time it had four furniture items available, three clothing items, two wallpapers, and two rugs that you could choose from. So, you know, things were pretty good at this point. And for many players, this was the last store that they would get, even if their game technically had a way to get one store bigger. We'll get to that soon. But in Wild World, Nookway returned, but instead it had five pieces of furniture, so one step better than before. And the exterior was more or less an upgrade from the old Nook N Go aesthetic. In City Folk, though, Nookway's outside would actually look different, redoing the signage and also adding a cool sign to the outside, which wasn't in the Wild World or GameCube versions of the game. And in Animal Crossing New Leaf, Nookway was replaced with TIY, which is partially like Nookway. There's a lot of similarities, though at the same time, this does pretty much take on a unique identity. So I'm not 100% sure if this one counts as the next evolution, other than it just being the third store option you could get. But you can see how some things have been rearranged in the 3DS version versus the Wii version. In the New Leaf version with TIY, it has a similar amount of items that Nookway would have, and it has a new expansion room for Leaf to sell stuff, which is really neat. They also sell KK's album here, which can change on a daily basis, which is cool too. Now, if we go forward all the way to the last and final Nook store upgrade across all the Animal Crossing games, we would be introduced to Nookington, which is supposed to be the premium shopping experience for Animal Crossing villagers and players. This time the exterior is this nice cream white. I think. But the building definitely looks a lot nicer, and you can tell that Nookington is going for that fancy department store vibe. In the original GameCube version, this was actually where the first appearances of Timmy and Tommy ever were, which is kind of interesting that these characters that are kind of major characters in the Animal Crossing universe were just these very small, obscure characters that only showed up in a version of Nook's store that most players couldn't experience. Now, this store had 6 pieces of furniture, 3 wallpapers, 3 floors that you could choose from, but the catch with the Nookington store was if you wanted to get this version of the store, not only did you have to spend 240,000 bells at Nookway, but you had to have had a friend on a different memory card come and visit and at least buy one item from your store. And the reason why a lot of people never got Nookington was because they never actually gave their memory card over to a friend to come visit, and then they never bought something from the store, which would trigger the upgrade in being possible once 240,000 bells were spent. Fortunately enough for me, when I was a kid though, I did have a friend who had Animal Crossing, and I went to his town and bought something, so he ended up getting the store. But when he came to my town, he didn't bring any bells and didn't buy anything, and all I got out of it was one of my villagers moving out of my town to go to his town. Yeah, I wasn't happy about that. In Animal Crossing Wild World, Nookington would return as well, having this time a little bit of a bigger exterior, and once again there were upgrade requirements before you would be able to get the store. Once again, you had to spend 240,000 bells at Nookway, but to get Nookington, you had to have a friend connect over Wi-Fi and buy something in your town as well, which back in 2005, not everyone had as easy access to Wi-Fi that they could connect to, and then also they had to know that their friend would be on at that perfect time to come and visit them. Though, if you were already internet savvy by 2005, you probably could make some friends online on some message board or something, and they'd come visit your town, and that, I remember, was a really big thing back then. So, maybe you were able to get Nookington on your DS all the way back then. Now, interestingly enough, when Wild World was re-released onto the Wii U through the virtual shop, they removed the requirement to have a friend come and buy something at the store. You would just get Nookingtons after spending 240,000 bells. And unfortunately, unless you do something weird with the local play with the DS connection, I don't think you're able to connect online anymore. So I'm not too sure on if Nookingtons is still unlockable with the DS version of Wild World, unless local play works still. It's kind of vague online. If you know the answer to this, do let me know in the comments down below. Once again, in Animal Crossing City Folk, they did a big upgrade to the aesthetic of Nookingtons. It looks really fancy, and they did some interesting things here. For instance, in the window, you can see that there's some clothes shown on the display, which I thought was really interesting because Nookingtons doesn't sell any clothes whatsoever. So that's kind of false advertising on Tom Nook's part, but you know, we'll give him a pass here. But by far, the biggest expansion in any Animal Crossing game comes in the form of the TNT Emporium in Animal Crossing New Leaf. Now, this one's really interesting because, well, obviously they were going for the ultimate shop design. They took a lot of inspiration from Nookington, but also made things unique and brought things to a new level. This time, instead of Leaf just having a separate room, he has his own gardening corner, which you can access in the first floor of the store. We also know that Timmy and Tommy Nook are spread out across 2 separate floors in this building. Before we go into the other floors or what's sold, the outside looks fantastic. It looks almost like an amusement park, not a department store. But hey, it's cool. There's things that you can buy here. Now, of course, on the first floor, you can see an interesting selection of things that you could buy, things you would expect in any type of Animal Crossing store to have. And when you travel up to the second floor, there's a wide variety of furniture that you can access as well. But the big thing that's interesting about TNT Emporium is there's actually a third floor to this store, which has Gracie Grace up there, a character who's been mostly forgotten about in New Horizons, who sells designer items, and they're essentially special and rare customized items you could buy for a premium price. Unfortunately, something like Nookington's or TNT Emporium never came back with Animal Crossing New Horizons, and it was something that I was holding out would have come in some sort of DLC update at some point, but it never actually did. It is interesting to think that over the course of every Animal Crossing game except New Horizons, the store had four variations, where New Horizons only has two, maybe three if you count the tent as a store variation, but we never actually got that ultimate version that a lot of fans expected. It's also worth noting that in Animal Crossing New Leaf, Nook Junction wasn't the only store to get upgrades. We also saw the Able Sisters getting upgrades, as well as the little town section of your village began to expand and grow. Eventually, there'd be a little shop front for Kicks. There would be a place for LaBelle to set up where you could get some cool accessories. Harriet set up a haircutting beauty store type thing, which was really cool. And a lot of these features would not be included in the store section of Animal Crossing New Horizons. Actually, for a very long time, some of these characters and features weren't even in the game, or they were limited to how often they would come and visit your island. Eventually, with the Happy Home Paradise update, we would see these characters find a permanent location over on Harv's Island, where you could then go and buy shoes any day of the week. You could see Katrina, you could look at some of the art from Red. And while these are kind of a different solution for the lack of their involvement in Animal Crossing New Horizons, it would have been nice to maybe have them on the main island instead of off on some little side island. I don't know. I liked the little city front that they introduced in City Folk and carried over into New Leaf, but I think I would even more like it if we could just build more stores on our main island and have even more than just the few buildings we are allowed to have. Maybe I'm biased because I like to have a city-themed island, but I'm all for just more buildings on the main island. Bring those Happy Home Paradise restaurants and cafes onto the island too. Just put it all on the main island, but that's my opinion. But wait, there's more appearances that we've seen of Nook stores outside of just the ones we've talked about so far. I always wonder if there was an Animal Crossing game that was going to be in development for the Wii U that never ended up being made because of the Wii U's player base, and maybe they chose to just do the spin-offs and start working on what would become the Switch version of the game. But way back when the Wii U launched and the game Nintendo Land came out, there was an Animal Crossing minigame, and in that minigame, you do get to see a Nook store from the outside. Interestingly enough, there is no name of the store. It's left blank, so we can't tell if it's a Nook's Cranny or a Nookling Junction, but it does look like a very modernized version of the store, unlike anything we'd seen in Animal Crossing up until that point. We actually would never see a blue-roofed and wood Nook's Cranny store until Animal Crossing New Horizons, and while I think that if there was a Wii U version of Animal Crossing in development at some point, it probably wouldn't look like this art style, I do wonder if maybe they looked at some assets for what would come in the Wii U version of Animal Crossing and styled the village based off of that, and a mix of the Nintendo Land art style, and this is what we got. It's purely speculation, but it is worth noting that it does look different here. In Super Smash Bros. For the Wii U, on the map Town and City, we can see a Nook store in the background, which lines up more closely to how Nook's Cranny looks in Animal Crossing City Folk, which is interesting because despite the fact that this game came out in 2014, 1 year after New Leaf, they still opted for using the older design of Nook's Cranny and not Nookling Junction. Then over in Mario Kart 8, there is an Animal Crossing racetrack, and this one once again has Nook's Cranny, though much bigger than what we actually see in the game. Once again, it is styled in the same design as what we would see in Wild World or City Folk, with the darker roof and shingles. Mind you, this was well after New Leaf had already released, with Nookling Junction being the main shop. Then also, I don't know if we should even count this one in the video, but we will for the sake of it, but in Animal Crossing Pocket Camp, seems like Timmy and Tommy got downgraded to just this little stall that they can roll around and sell stuff like cookies too. I mean, it's not that big of a deal, but it's kind of funny. And if we're gonna do all the spinoffs in Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival, we don't get a good look at either version of the store, though we do get a quick glimpse inside of the store during one of like the little event things that happen. And it does look like it's either Tommy or Timmy inside of the store, meaning that it's very likely Nookling Junction that shows up in this version. Also, we don't actually see the store in the overworld, meaning it could be in the little town section up above, making this most likely more closely based off of Animal Crossing New Leaf. And I think outside of that, if I'm understanding it correctly, that's every single version of a Nook store across the entire franchise. There was a lot to unpack, a lot of different little variations, but it was a lot of fun going through memory lane and looking and speculating as to why some of these decisions were made. Hey, if you like this video, make sure you subscribe, and we'll see you guys next time with some more Animal Crossing stuff.